Hey guys, hope you all are doing well. Firstly, I just want to say it feels so good to be sitting back on this couch chatting with you guys. I know that it's been a while. I swear the month of April just completely escaped me. Like, I blinked and it was already May. And I know a lot of that has to do with the fact that April was my birthday month. It was also my daughter's first birthday, and we did have family that flew out for the occasion. So there was just a lot going on the past like 3 weeks now. So yeah, it feels good to be talking with you guys, and I do, of course, have a Bath & Body Works haul to share with you. So they did recently have some pretty good sales, which I've been waiting for every day for a good sale from Bath & Body Works. So it finally came around. They had 2-for-1 3-wick candles, which I did pick up a bunch of new ones, and then I also took advantage of their $6.50 body moisturizer sale as well. And I have to say, this is probably one of my favorite purchases I've ever made from Bath & Body Works, because usually when I make large online orders, especially if it's items I've never smelled before, it's a little bit of a hit and miss situation. I usually end up loving like maybe half of what I get, and then the other half I'm kind of like indifferent about. This time around, I sincerely love every single thing that I got, so I am so excited to share it with you guys, and let's go ahead and jump straight into it. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the body moisturizers. Again, these were $6.50 each. And the first one I picked up was Magnolia Charm. She comes in this beautiful dark black packaging, and then you have the really pretty delicate magnolias on the front there. I really love the contrast of those two things for the packaging. I feel like it's very eye-catching and something a little bit different from what I feel like we typically see from Bath & Body Works, where it's usually like very bright and happy. I just love that they chose like a dark packaging. Now, I have to say, this was a scent that I was really trying hard to avoid because, firstly, I'm not much of a floral person, but secondly, I just have so many body care items at this point. I was like, if I'm gonna try something new, it's gotta be something that I know I'm going to love, and a floral usually just is not it for me. But when I was reading reviews on this scent, one word that kept popping up was the word fresh. And if you know me, I am such a sucker for anything that is described as clean or fresh. So I was like, you know what? There's a sale. I'm just gonna go ahead and try it out. And I am really glad that I did pick this up. So the notes for this are dewy pear blossom, blooming magnolia, and fresh cedar. And it does smell really good. That magnolia is very much present. I do get a little bit of that juicy pear in there as well. It is a floral, but I can understand the very fresh description of it because it doesn't smell too overly perfumey or stuffy to me. It definitely has a nice brightness to it that I do think is really nice and refreshing. I do get a little bit of that cedar in there as well. Probably not something that I would pick up in the shower gel version, just because it's not, you know, there are those certain scents where you only like them in certain form. Like for me, this is perfect as a moisturizer. I feel like the heat of the shower always really intensifies a scent, and for something like this that's already pretty strong, I just don't think I would want it as like a shower experience. But as a moisturizer, I do think it's really nice and a really pretty scent. The next scent I picked up was Pretty as a Peach, and it looks like that. I love the writing on there. I also love this kind of like copper rose gold lid that it has. So this is the 24-hour moisture body lotion. I don't think I even saw the body cream. I probably would have picked that up instead, but I just went ahead and got the lotion. And the notes for this are blushing peach, jasmine petals, white nectarine, apple blossom, and sheer freesia. Now, I love that they combined a peach with nectarine and blossom, because when you think of all three of those fruits, like when you bite into them, they're very like crisp when you bite into them. They have almost like a slight tartness to them when you first bite into them, and this really does capture that. It just smells like a first bite of like a summer peach, like straight off of the tree, and you take that bite and the juice runs down your face. Like, this gives me all those feelings, and I just love it. It's such a happy, beautiful scent, and I think so perfect for summer. The next one I picked up is the Aromatherapy Sleep Rose Lavender. This is one of the only lavender scents I have not tried from Bath & Body Works, so I figured I would go ahead and pick her up. And yeah, it smells very rosy, but it's a very true rose. It's not like a perfumey type of rose to me. It does smell really earthy and true to like a rose scent. You do get that little bit of lavender kind of hanging out in the background, which is really nice. It adds a little bit of earthiness. It sort of cuts out of that rosy scent a little bit. And I do think that the two really complement each other very well. So I was actually pleasantly surprised with that guy. And then the final one I picked up is another Air. If you don't already know, this is by far my favorite scent from Bath & Body Works. And I'm so sad that I feel like they might be slowly phasing this one out, only because I didn't see the body wash online, and even my local stores aren't fully stocked with this anymore. So hopefully they don't take it away. If they do, it's not that big of a deal, I'm sure. I will fall in love with something else, but yeah, this is the Air Lavender Eucalyptus Spearmint and Mandarin. I can't say enough good things about it. It is so relaxing. It's invigorating. I love that it has like that soothing quality from the lavender, but it has that little bit of eucalyptus in there that adds a little bit of like cleansing and clarity. And I don't feel like the eucalyptus overpowers the lavender, which to me is very rare for a Bath & Body Works scent. Usually I feel like when eucalyptus is in there, it just takes over everything. Like, it is the star of the show, but not so much in this scent. And then you have that bit of spearmint, mandarin. The combination is just really beautiful, and I'm obviously obsessed with it. Okay, friends, we are now going to get into the candles. Are you ready? Let's go. So the first one I picked up is Warm Ocean Breeze, and it looks like that. It's got those little palm trees on there. It kind of reminds me of like a surf shop type of packaging. And the notes for Warm Ocean Breeze are ocean sandalwood, warm sage, eucalyptus zest, and coconut. Now, this is a brand new scent for me. I've never smelled it before, so I wasn't sure what to expect, but it does smell so good. I get a lot of the sandalwood in here, so it is a slightly heavier scent. It's not something I feel like I could burn probably in my bedroom, but maybe in my living area where there's a little bit more ventilation going on, I feel like this would probably work very well. Don't get a ton of the sage, maybe a slight hint of that eucalyptus, and also the coconut too is very, very light in this, which I'm happy about because I feel like coconut is another one of those scents that tends to take over the fragrance, but it really doesn't with this, at least just smelling it so far. It kind of just smells like sitting out on vacation, like at a resort somewhere, and you're like laying out and someone near you has like a pina colada, and just like the ocean breeze comes by and kind of wafts the scent of the drink in your nose. Like, it's not anything too heavy and fragrant, but you just get a little hit of the coconut. It smells like vacation to me, like relaxing, and yeah, I'm actually very pleasantly surprised by that guy as well. The next one I picked up was Fresh Spring Morning. Obsessed with the packaging for this. It is so pretty. And this was another new scent for me. The notes of it are spring morning dew, aloe blossoms, and creamy orange flower. And I do get that fresh early morning from this, which is one thing I really love about Bath & Body Works, is I love when they can really capture a moment for you, kind of like with the peach, where it, I feel like they capture that fresh first bite of a peach. I really do feel like they capture early morning dew with this, which I think is really nice. It's very clean, it's very fresh. To me, it's a little bit of an unexpected scent too. Like, usually with the clean, fresh scents, I feel like they sometimes kind of all blend together, but this does smell really beautiful and kind of hard to describe, but I really like it. The next one I got is Sea Salt and Balsam. I am so excited to burn this candle because I love the packaging. I love that you're able to see through the glass, and then you just have these little, I don't know, is this balsam plant? I don't know if it's seagrass. I don't know what is going on here, but I love that you're going to be able to see the flames kind of peek through the little plants going on. I just love the look of that. The notes of this are salted ocean air, crisp coastal waves, and ocean balsam. Yeah, it smells so good. I was scared with the balsam scent that it was gonna kind of just smell like Christmas at the beach or something, but it totally doesn't. Even though that would be such a cute candle name, Bath & Body Works, take note, Christmas at the beach would be such a cute holiday candle. But yeah, the balsam in there is just really fresh and clean. You have a little bit of that sea salt in there, and sometimes sea salt scents tend to be somewhat nauseating to me depending on how they're combined with certain things, but it really doesn't smell nauseating to me at all in this. I feel like this is totally a candle you would burn and someone would walk in and say like, oh my gosh, what is that scent? It is sea salt and balsam. The next one I picked up is laundry day, which let me tell you, I'm so sad that I did not go in store to smell this, because had I done so, I would have picked up at least two more of this because I love this scent. So the notes of it are fresh air, crisp eucalyptus, and soft lavender. And it just smells like your laundry straight out of the dryer. But to me, I know some people have described it as like, oh, it just smells like straight laundry detergent. I don't agree with that. I actually do think there was another scent that Bath & Body Works came out with, and I can't think of the name of it at the moment, that to me did smell just like straight up Tide detergent or like Clorox or something. To me, this definitely is a lot softer than that. I almost get more of like a dryer sheet type of scent. I don't necessarily get detergent, but like fabric softener, dryer sheet type of smell, just because it isn't quite as pungent to me as like a laundry detergent, but it smells so good. This is totally one of those candles I could see myself burning at the end of the day in the bedroom after I've cleaned the house and everything is ready to go, and I could just burn this and bask in my accomplishment for the day, which let me tell you, as a mom, cleaning the house is a huge accomplishment, okay? So yeah, it's the little things, right? I especially love the packaging for it, and it's probably one of my favorite scents I picked up in this order. The next one I picked up is Lemon Mint Leaf, which again has that really pretty pattern on the jar where you just have like the leaves and then you have that wax peeking through, and it's just gonna look so pretty as it burns. And the notes for this are sparkling lemon zest, spearmint leaves, and verbena sprigs. And it smells exactly what you would expect. It smells like lemony, minty. Tina Marie here on YouTube, who I probably talk about in every single video because I'm obsessed with her channel, but she does tons of Bath & Body Works videos. And I remember one time she mentioned that this is a good scent if you're ever feeling stuffy or sick to light this, and it's gonna help clear your sinuses. And I've always kind of had that in the back of my mind. So I figured, you know what? I love the packaging. I'm just gonna go ahead and get it. I do like the scent regardless. Like, if I never get like a cold or stuffiness, I would burn it regardless. But I always have that like in the back of my mind, like, you know what, this is good to have for those days if I'm stuffy or if the baby is feeling a little bit sick, just to burn this, and it will hopefully kind of help clear our sinuses up. Okay, the next one I have is an online exclusive. It is the White Lavender Eucalyptus. It comes in this very sort of unexpected purple packaging. Even though it is lavender, I don't know why I wasn't expecting like a purple jar for this. It's kind of like a opaque jar. And the notes of this are crisp eucalyptus, sweet spearmint leaves, and soft lavender. Obviously, the notes are somewhat reminiscent of air body care, so I'm sure I would like this. And I do really like it. There is a little bit of like a sourness to this that I have a hard time understanding where it's coming from. I'm hoping that once I burn it, that will dull down a little bit, but I get the eucalyptus and the spearmint. I get a little bit of the lavender, but there is almost kind of like a slight soury scent to this, which is honestly a little bit off-putting when you first smell it, but I'm really hoping as I burn it, the oils will just kind of mix together and it's gonna smell beautiful. It does smell really good. There's just a slight like sourness to it, which we'll have to figure out. The next one I picked up, another packaging win for me, is Tea Rose. Now mine actually did come with a little blemish on there, which is kind of sad, but I don't think it's that noticeable to return it, so I'll still hold on to it. But yeah, look at how gorgeous the packaging is. And the notes of this are sweet pink rose petals, fresh white tea, and dewy greens. I love this scent, and I'm not even a big floral person. I love this scent. This smells like a very true rose to me. It gives me like such a happy feeling when I smell it, because it reminds me if like you've ever received flowers for Valentine's Day, your birthday, or any occasion, and you smell that bouquet. It's such a distinct scent, like a bouquet smell. And to me, I get like fresh cut roses from this. It smells so freaking good. I like the tea in there as well. I feel like it takes away again from like that perfumey feeling that rose tends to typically have. Almost like you are like in a tea garden somewhere, like a rose garden, and having tea somewhere. To me, this is what it would smell like. So it's beautiful, fresh, fragrant. I really love it. I honestly might pick up another one of those. Okay guys, last candle. The final one I picked up is Salted ocean air. And I'm not even gonna lie, it was 100% the packaging that made me definitely want to pick this up because I love the little like rainbow packaging on here. I feel like this is probably my favorite packaging so far with the candles they've released for spring and summer. And the notes for this one are fresh ocean mist, warm summer winds, and beach musk. I do get that bit of warmth in there that they're talking about. A little bit of that beach musk. It's really hard to describe. That's probably why they describe it as like fresh ocean mist, warm summer winds, but slightly florally, kind of, but very beachy, very clean, fresh, very distinct in the scent. Like it's not one of those like ocean water scents where it smells like really mild, almost like you can't smell anything. Like this has a very distinct scent to it, but it's very clean and fresh and my kind of scent, my kind of packaging. So nothing but good things to say about that one as well. Yeah, that is it, guys, for this haul. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to give the video a like. And if you're new to my channel, definitely do not forget to subscribe. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye.